Hello everybody, welcome back, and today we'll be making a herringbone stitch. This is how it looks. So I've decided to combine my yarn because I used double knit, but because I'm using the bigger crochet, I decided that I feel it's easy when you put take this the shorter part of your yarn to your left, to your right, to your left on your needle. Just make a twist and start crocheting. There you have a knot. Now we are going to chain 15. This is how you chain. This is 1, 2, 3. So you are going to start on the second stitch from your chain. This is the first, which is the 15th one. This is the 14th stitch. So we are going to just go down because you're doing a single crochet to start it. Start our herringbone. So that's our single crochet. So now we are going to start the herringbone stitch. We are going to insert your hook on that space and go down to your chain, and on that space, and yarn over, pull everything out, and you start again. You're going to insert your hook on the bottom part of your stitch. And go to your chain, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull everything out, and go again on that bottom stitch, chain, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull everything out. Go down to that stitch again. On your chain, pull through, yarn over, pull through, and pull everything out. This was the last stitch. So we have our 14th herringbone stitch. So at the end here, we are going to chain one. Now you're going to turn your work. That's when we are doing the reverse herringbone. The way your yarn is, this is how you hold everything. We are going to take your yarn, your hook, and put it behind this yarn. Your working yarn, in fact, it has to be in the front now. So hold it like this. And turn your work like this. So you put your yarn here at the back, and it should come through the side on this space. You can see. I want to show you something. So if you were to use your left hand, this is how this looks like. We are going to insert. Put your yarn there, insert your hook in there, going through that 1, 2, 3, under those 3 loops. So that's how it looks like when you're using your hand, your right hand. So we are going to put your yarn in the front and put your hook on that space. Yarn over, there you go. You should let your hook face up when you're turning it, because it's not like because it's a reverse thing, just put it there and we do the single crochet facing up like that. And now our herringbone starts again. On this loop here at the back, we have one and two. On the back here, we are going to insert your hook there and insert your hook under those three loops. This is the first loop. This is the second loop. This is the third loop. So you're going to insert your hook there and you do the same thing again. Your needle has to face up, but you have to insert your hook first there. On that single crochet, you insert your hook there before you go down under those three loops. Hook it, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, and you pull everything out. You're going to do the same thing again. This one, two, three, just like in the front loop, but this is a reverse part of it. So you're going to insert your hook there in the lower part of that single crochet. You go to the stitches under those three loops. Here, as you can see, we are left with two stitches. This is the last one. So this is the second to last. You're going to insert your needle there. Can you see it? We insert your hook and we do that again. Pull everything out. Now we are left with this one has only two loops. So we are going to go to the first one there on your stitch, and then now we have to work on this last stitch. This is the last stitch. You're going to insert your hook there. It only has two loops. And chain one. So you're going to turn again to your work, and you see now our herringbone has formed.